Welcome back to the Pinnacle Exceptional Driver Championship. 128 made their way to Laughlin Ranch for the finals competition, including the lone female, Jarena Mendoza. The senior who attends the University of Texas at El Paso narrowly missed reaching the final eight.
I know I qualified at 43 and I saw some 80s and I was going, wow, you know, I don't even know if I have a chance. And coming up here and making it to the semifinals, I'm pretty proud of myself.
In the early rounds, Jarena had the best streak of the week, hitting 17 in a row on the grid. Also in the Sweet 16, there was a father-son duo, one of last year's finalists, David Buckles and his son, Jared, and former NFL quarterback Billy Joe Hobert gave it his best shot.
I'm an egomaniac, and I'm more interested. I'm a trophy guy. I want to see the trophy. I'm very comfortable playing football. When you set up that line, you know you got to hit it within this little 40-yard grid. It's a little nerve-wracking, and yeah, it got to me.
Semifinal number one set to go. David Gurnow and Tom Brundage getting set here at this Pinnacle Exceptional Driver Championship presented by Honda. And Gurnow will be the first to play.
Brundage had the option of going first or second. He decided to go second. That's the first time anybody's chosen that option.
Gurnow was in the engineering and construction business. Matter of fact, Andy, right after this competition, he's got to get on a plane and go to Saudi Arabia.
So hit 4 out of 4 in the grid the first round and starting out the second round with a wide right.
Now swing number two for David Gurnow, the eighth seed in this competition. David also has worked on the design side of the golf course business. So besides being an accomplished player, he's a golf course designer, but is not able to find the grid on his first two swings here. So now Tom Brundage, the fifth seed, with the door wide open.
Brundage tees the ball higher than any of our finalists.
He really does. But they make tees specifically for players that like the TMI.
It has definitely changed over the years. Now you get tees 4, 5, 6 inches long if you want them now.
I remember when Chichi Rodriguez used to have to make his tall tees himself.
He actually teed up on a pencil.
Yeah. Now swing number two for Brundage. That's much better right there for the 6'7" power hitter. And right down the middle. So just short of the number 12, that's going to be, well, they're going to give him 12. That is right there on the line.
See,
it is just on the line. So 12 points for Tom Brundage. Gurnow, swing number three.
He knows he has to put these next two balls in the grid. Just good rhythm. Try not to hit it too hard. That was better.
Much better swing there.
Really finished that swing nicely.
On the left side of the grid.
It's going to get him 9 points. So he's back in the match.
So Gurnow is on the board. And he just trails by 3. So very important to get this fourth swing in and put the pressure back on Tom Brundage. So the fourth swing for David Gurnow. And that's another good one. So after missing his first two, got 9 points on swing number three, and this will run up just about to the same spot there, so 9 more points for the number 8 seed. Now Tom Brundage is third swing, and Andy, we talked about that tee. USGA specs no longer than 4 inches.
Come back.
For this competition.
Yeah.
That one's wide right, so all of a sudden the pressure on Tom Brundage to put this next ball in play.
Boy, look at the tape on the hands there. He's hit a lot of golf balls this week, as all of these players have.
And a very strong grip.
So on swing number four, he is going to miss the grid once again to the right. So Brundage only 1 out of 4 in. Gurnow has hit his last two. And now the fifth and final and important swing here for David Gurnow. We mentioned a very solid player, but quit playing golf for about 10 years because he just couldn't putt anymore. Then he discovered the claw grip, and it brought him back.
The claw saved a lot of players. And if he can get this ball in the grid, it could be the winning shot.
The swing looked good. And looking down the left side, lands on. Oh, and what a hard bounce to the left.
The fact that this grid slopes from left to right. Now the ball is in Tom Brundage's court. He has to score in the grid. 7 or higher.
Is that the keep it in play, swing right there.
Yes.
Right. Whoa. On the line. Goodness. Oh, that was ever so close, but it landed in, stayed right on the line there, Andy.
That's,
and it's
three
good.
Three inches difference between victory and defeat.
About a T length.
That's exactly right. Wow.
So 9 points there for Brundage as we send it to Art.
You chose to go second there, and you had the hammer. You knew exactly what you did, had to do right there to come through. What was your thought before you took that golf club back?
Just to get it in the grid somewhere.
And just barely enough, but it was enough. And Tom Brundage moves on to the finals here at the Pinnacle Exceptional Driver Championship. Semifinal match number two, second-seeded Ron Mangold, third-seeded Scott Iono. And Mangold very consistent with his first swing in the semifinal match. And, Andy, that was extremely solid right there.
Really important to get off to that top start, and the best seed gets to pick if he goes first or second. Ron has decided he wants those first two swings.
So Mangold with 9 points on swing number one, and here comes swing number two for the resident of Arkansas. 9 happy with that one. He's made a lot of good swings, but that is the worst we've seen from him.
All it takes is to lose your rhythm just a minute second, and all of a sudden it's off the grid.
So now third seeded Scott Iono. Mangold with one of his first two. Let's see what kind of start Scott can get off to.
Coming off those three straight 14 pointers.
Oh, that is very solid there. That's turning from left to right to the middle of the grid. And so for Scott Iono, that's going to be 11 points. And Art Selinger, he has got some real rhythm and tempo working right now. What about this young man's swing?
It is pure. It is Tiger-esque. He's got a 48-inch driver, and he has got nothing but free swinging action. I love how he gets that chest to that target. I don't see any fear here at all.
Yeah. Oh, and he loves this one. He absolutely loves it. And why not? Look at this thing turning from left to right and onto the 12 spot. So a great start there for Scott, Andy.
And he is in a nice groove right now. Great rhythm going, a lot of confidence. Now a lot of pressure back on Ron.
Oh, absolutely. So Mangold now with swing number three. 9 points on his first swing. Couldn't find the grid on swing number two. And he's just sort of out of sorts right now.
Well, he knows he's not as long as Scott, so he's probably overdoing it just a little bit versus just trying to make sure he keeps putting it in the grid and putting pressure on Scott to have to perform.
Yeah, he's been so solid and had such great tempo throughout the earlier rounds, but now in a real pressure situation, this swing number four, he's missed his last two. A little better there. Looks like that's going to be on the grid. It is. Finds the right side over there and turning back to the middle. So he got 11 points on that one. So Ron Mangold now with 20. And here comes Scott Iono. He needs 12 points or higher to win the semifinal match. Oh, it gets great extension there, doesn't he, Andy?
That's all caused by the big turn going back.
Come on!
He is on a roll right now. Nice kick.
Yeah,
it's in.
You bet. And all the way down to 12. So there it is. Scott Iono will advance on to the finals. And now the O'Reilly Golf Track.
The fact that Iono got all three of his balls in play, put the pressure on Mango. Now he's with Art.
Scott, you look on right now. You are filling it up and hitting it big. You're not holding anything back. You had two balls there to get 12 points, and you took one for 13. How are you feeling going into the finals?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. I'm ready.
All right.
Let's get it on.
All right, he's ready.
Well, his family cheering him on, and whatever butterflies Scott Iono had in the early part of this competition, they are gone, folks. One match remains here in Laughlin, one step closer to naming a champion. Will Tom Brundage or Scott Iono drive away with the all-new 2007 Honda S2000 and $50,000?